In this video, I'm going to talk about calories. This topic is probably one of the most confusing things that you can ever imagine. So really pay attention, because this is a really important video. You know, every so often I'll have people come in and say, you know, Dr. Berg, I'm not eating that many calories. I don't know why I'm not losing weight. I mean, I'm practicing portion control. I'm eating everything in moderation. Why can't I lose weight? Because I read in a book that it's just a matter of calories in equal calories out and you will lose weight, right? Well, let me just go a little bit deeper. So let's first define what a calorie is. Calories are units of energy in food, okay? It's a unit of energy in food. So we have three basic types of food. We have proteins, we have fats, and we have carbohydrates. So let's just talk about proteins, first of all. Proteins have 4 calories per gram, and fats have 9 calories per gram, and carbohydrates have 4 calories per gram. So now, if you didn't understand about the hormone system, which we'll get into, you would look at this and go, wow, look at those fats. It contains more than twice the calories, so therefore, I'm going to avoid fats and then it's going to help me lose weight. Well, let's take a look at what occurs as another layer on top of these calories, because the way the body manipulates these calories is very different than a machine. You have hormones that react and influence all these three very differently, okay? So the first thing I'm going to talk about is the hormones involved when you eat protein. Now, if you have a small amount of protein, maybe 3 to 4 ounces, you will trigger the fat-burning hormones to help you burn fat. Now, I want to mention what proteins, the function of proteins in the body, actually are there to replace and build body tissue, like muscle, like ligament, like collagen, like your joints, like your hair, your nails. A lot of the cell structures are all made from protein. Certain hormones are made from protein. So that's why we need protein. We're constantly replacing the body with the structure of the material of protein and through the hormone cycle, all right? So if you actually consume too much protein, like a very large amount, then what happens is you'll trigger the opposite hormone called insulin, and that makes fat. Okay, so excessive protein can cause fat storage. And so so really, proteins can help you or they can hurt you depending on the amount. Now, I want to talk about fats. Fat has the most calories, but as far as hormones are involved, it's neutral. As far as insulin, it does not trigger the fat-making hormones, so it's neutral. Now, I'm not saying that if you consume all this fat that it could influence your ability to get fat. I'm not saying to start eating tons of fat, but I am saying there's a diet out there called the ketosis diet, and it's used for children with seizures, and it's also involved in the Atkins diet, which is basically a high-protein diet, and ketosis is basically a breakdown of fat in the body, and the fat's converted to ketones, and the ketones is used as fuel instead of sugar. So in other words, the Atkins diet works like this. It's very high protein and high fat and very low, if any, carbohydrates. Okay? So we have high protein, high fat, and a lot of people lose weight with that. So why? Because when you eat that much fat and oil, it forces your body to release your own fat. So in other words, fat doesn't necessarily always turn in the fat. Now, then why, Dr. Berg, don't I recommend the Atkins diet? Well, first of all, it's missing the nutrients. There's not enough vitamins and minerals in fat and protein to be able to sustain the body. Plus, it's very hard on your liver. If you have all this fat that's being burnt through the body, it all has to come out through your liver, which is 3.5 pounds right here, and it can plug up the liver and create all sorts of problems like a fatty liver. It can block your liver from detoxification. You can have bad breath. It creates a lot of side effects. It's not the healthiest way to lose weight. Yet a lot of people will do it and they will lose weight, but it's not a long-term thing. So fats are neutral with making fat, but it also will force your body to burn up your own fat, but fat's used as an energy source and to satisfy the hunger as well. There is some nutrients in fats, but not a lot. Now, we have carbohydrates. Now, the carbohydrates, depending on what kind of carbohydrate, will either cause you to make fat or burn fat. So, the carbohydrates consisted of sugars, okay, and that would be refined grains like breads, pasta, cereal, crackers, biscuits, waffles, pancakes, muffins, sodas, things like that, juice, hidden sugars in yogurt, alcohol, all that will trigger, even though it's a smaller amount of calories, will trigger insulin, which will make fat. So carbohydrates are converted into fat if they break down the sugar really fast. Okay, so that's one thing. Number two, the vegetables that we're talking about, vegetables are carbohydrates. The non-sweet vegetables, the non-starchy vegetables, have a lot of nutrition and a lot of fiber and low sugar. So those things do not convert to fat at all, and that's why we recommend them, because it's a very good sustaining thing that you can do for the liver, because it enhances the nutrition into the body. It gives you all the vitamins and minerals that we need to convert the proteins and fats to body tissues. Okay? So that's why we do recommend the non-sweet carbohydrates. Now, of course, potatoes and rice and the starchy ones also are sugary and they convert into fat as well, but the vegetable family does not. So what I wanted just to make you aware of is the calories of these really react differently to hormones. And it's not as simple as calories in equals calories out. It really depends on what type of carbohydrates. One purpose of fat, one of the purposes of fat would be to build the body tissue as well. Every single cell in your body, the outer part of the cell wall, is made from fat. Your brain is made from fat. Your hormones are made from fat. All the nervous system, the covering around the nerves, are made from fat. All your skin is made from fat. So you need certain fat to replace that. You need fat and protein to build the body, but you need the vitamins and minerals from the carbohydrates, the vegetable carbohydrates, to provide the nutrition to allow these to work. And that is the purpose of nutrition, is to allow the raw material to be converted into body tissue, to allow that egg that you eat to be turned into your hair. You need vitamins and minerals at the DNA level, and that's why we have these nutrients, to help repair and build body tissue. Okay, so I hope that's a good summary of what a calorie is. I'm expanding your definition. Now, what goes wrong is when you age, the hormones change, your metabolism changes. And what I just talked about is even more important, because now you're going to have to be very, very strict on how many carbs you allow into your body. And you have to understand the function of proteins and fats and really keep the diet clean if you want to lose any weight. Because you can't do what you did when you're 18, when your metabolism and hormones were at their peak. So the more the hormones decrease towards 50, this becomes more and more important. But when you're 18, you probably could lower your calories and lose weight just like that. Now you can't. Now we also have, if you've ruined your metabolism and you have a slow metabolism, this becomes even more important as well. So sometimes I'll have people say, Dr. Berg, am I ever going to go back to being able to eat Twinkies again? I'll say, well, you don't have the luxury right now. Let's build back up your metabolism so then this becomes less of a problem and you can eat more Twinkies if you want to eat one once in a blue moon. Also, so hormones are affected by food and they're influenced by aging and they're influenced by metabolism. So I hope that expanded your idea on what a calorie is. And the next time someone says everything in moderation, well, not if you are getting older, not if you have a slow metabolism, that doesn't work. And also portion control. Even a small amount of refined carbs and sugar can really block your ability to burn fat for a long period of time. So this does not apply if you have problems with the hormone. Okay, I hope that helped.